Dear sir, madam, gentlemen, lady, professor, researcher, and everyone here, today I'm very honored and happy to present my research, my report, my research, tutorial on Bayesian optimization. I am Professor Dr. Lộc Nguyễn from Vietnam, and this is my affiliation, Ngoc Nguyễn@academic.net.org. This is my home, my email and my home base, and I'm very honored and happy to connect with all of you. Abstract: machine learning falls into three main tiers, such as supervised learning and unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning, where reinforcement learning is the most potential to artificial intelligence AI application. But because it solves real problems by classical rest in which possible solutions are improved and fine-tuned continuously. The progressive approach, which reflects the ability of adaptation, is appropriate to the real world, where smart events occur and change continuously and unexpectedly. Moreover, data is getting to use for supervised learning and unsupervised learning to draw variable knowledge from such huge data, user data at one time. Bayesian optimization builds models an optimization problem as a probabilistic form called surrogate models, and then directly maximize an acquisition function related from such surrogate model in order to maximize implicitly and indirectly the target function for finding our solution of the optimization problem. A popular surrogate model is Gaussian process regression model. The concept of maximizing acquisition function is based on updating posterior probability of surrogate model repeatedly, which is improved after every iteration. Taking advantage of acquisition function or utility function is also common in decision theory, but the semantic meaning behind BOS is that BOS solves problem by progressive and adaptive approach via updating surrogate models from small piece of data at each time, according to ideology of reinforcement learning. Undoubtedly, BOS is reinforcement learning algorithm with many potential applications, and thus it is surveyed in this research by attention to its mathematical ideas. Moreover, the solution of optimization is important to not only apply the mathematics but also AI. Table contains 1. Introduction to Bayesian optimization. 3. Gaussian complex regression for acquisition functions. 5. Discussion. Given target function y equals fs, optimization problem is to find out extreme measure s star so that fs star gets extreme value y star equals fs star. As a convention, fs is the scalar by vector function whose input observed value and evaluated values y is scalar and whose variable s is an n-dimension vector. The extremizer s star can be minimizer or maximizer so that y star is minimum or maximum respectively. Optimization is specified by equation 111. If the extremizer s star is local minimizer or local maximizer, the optimization problem is local optimization problem where traditional methods such as Resin descent are perfect Aberfett Solutions, but they require FSE totally convexed for minimization or concave for maximization. The rub gum becomes much becomes much more complex if FS is not totally convex concave with witness that S-star is the global extremizer. This is the global optimization problem where is mentioned in this research a usual S-star is a minimizer by default, but in context of Bayes and optimization below, is it better to consider S-star is as a maximizer because BOs mainly relate to probability distributions whose peaks are concerned much. However, it is not serious because minimization is inverse of maximization, for example, here. Minimize FS is equivalent to maximize minus FS. Moreover, introduction. This is session introduction. Moreover, which one among the minimization or maximization can be determined by changing activation function, acquisition function, a little bit in BO. There are three approaches to solve the global optimization problem set A: analytic function, approach, probabilistic approach, and heuristic approach. Analytic approach applies mathematical tool into the finding out optimizer approximation, cutting length, range and bounds, and interval method, in which these methods focus on analytic action of algebraic target function. Probabilistic approach considers looking for optimized as a random selection, but random selection is guided by some probabilistic models so as to reach an optimizer. Heuristic approach, which is the most flexible one among three approaches, tries to apply or imitate heuristic assumptions into searching for optimizers. It does not concern much mathematical reasoning because feasibility and effectiveness are most important. As usual, heuristic approach imitates natural activities, for example, particle swarm optimization, BSO, simulates how a flock of birds search for food. Evolutionary algorithms like BSO and Ong-Bee colony, ABC, which are inspired from biological activities are popular method or heuristic algorithm. However, there are some implicit connections between heuristic approach, concretely evolution algorithm, and probabilistic approach in a research rise by law that I research in here. Bayesian optimization belongs to the probabilistic approach. It is based on Bayesian inference, which consider parameter as a random variable and updates the posterior probability of parameter based on evidence and prior probability. Because the BO does not impact directly on target function FS, it must model FS as a probabilistic model and then define an acquisition function for such probabilistic model. BO solves the optimization problem by maximizing the acquisition function instead of maximizing the target function. Shortly, two main tasks of BO are modeling FS by the probabilistic model called circuit model, defining the acquisition function for circuit model so that it is possible to maximize the acquisition function. Posterior probability of circuit models in BO update is updated continuously along with maximizing acquisition function continuously until a maximizer of target function is reached. Next slide is the pseudo cock of BO. Table 1.1 BO algorithm. This is the description of BO algorithm. Model FS by the circuit models S, where SF given DN, where sample DN is a set of variables FI, define the acquisition function alpha S given FS based on both FS and the circuit models SF of F given DN whose variable is S. Initialize N and initialize randomly DN S1, S2, Sn. Why? Maximizer S star is not reached or the number of iterations is not many enough. Update the material probability of S of the circuit model S with sample DN and determine acquisition function alpha of S given FS with the circuit model S. Find the position S n plus 1 is a maximizer of the acquisition function alpha with regard to S here. And checking whether S n plus 1 is maximizer S star, and later add S n plus 1 to sample DN here. And increase answer by 1. And the loop is repeat again. In the table above, there is a question about how to check if a given Sn plus 1 is the global maximizer S star. The checking task here is implicitly executed by BO application, for example, if two or more sequential equations produce the same value Sn plus 1 equals Sn, or small enough the variation n plus 1 subtract S1, such value Sn plus 1 can be the maximizer S star or be considered as a maximizer S star because BO algorithm improves Sn plus 1 to be higher and higher by maximizing updated acquisition function after every iteration. Because the checking class is not essential class of BO, it is often not listed in BO literature. Besides, how to define acquisition function can decide which one among the maximization or minimization is the optimization problem. Continue introduction. If the circuit models S of F given DN has explicit parameters related directly to FS, updating posterior probability of the model S is indeed to update the posterior probability of its explicit parameters, and then BO is called parametric BO, PBO. If the surrogate model S has no explicit parameters, or its parameters are not related directly to FS, then BO is called non-parametric BO or NBO. As seen in BO algorithm, BOs do not concern algebraic formulation of target function FS because it only concerns output Y equal FS, and hence FS is a nut box. FS is a nut box with regard to BO. In other words, FS is an arbitrary mapping with subject to BO. And so BO is a flexible function, a solution for the global optimization which has many potential applications. For bio, especially NBO, FSE, Blackbox, either Blackbox except its output wide, and so bio maximize the acquisition function alpha of S given FS, instead of maximizing directly FS because BIOS knows alpha S given the acquisition function alpha, which is created from the model, the circuit model S that BIOS built up before. How to define acquisition function depends on which kind of BIOS is, for instance, PBO or NBO, and how to define surrogate models, BIO and acquisition function will be mentioned in next sessions. In general, the essence of BIO is a continuous improvement via updating posterior reliability, which follows the ideology of reinforcement learning. And we move to the session 2, Bayesian optimization. I aforementioned Bayesian optimization BIO solves the optimization problem by maximizing the acquisition function alpha of S given F, the surrogate model S, which is derived from the surrogate models S, where DN is the current sample. The surrogate models S in turn was a probabilistic representation of target function FS. The way to define surrogate models decides the kind of BIO where there are two kinds of BIO, such as parametric BIO, PBIO, and non-parametric BIO, NBIO. PBIO implies the parameter of surrogate model S, which included explicitly in target function FS. Otherwise, the surrogate models S of NBO has no explicit parameter, or its parameters were not included explicitly in target function FS. Thirdly, PBO is surveyed and then NBO is researched. The simplest PBO is by a system consisting of R event SK. SK is known. SK is known. Binary system, for example, a lottery machine or bandit system, has R arms represented by R random variable SK, and probability of an arm K, yielding lottery. Authorizer is this derivative is B. SK equal 1. Such PBO is called binary PBO, where it binary random variable SK whose outcome is successful. SK is equal 1 and failed SK equal 0. Follows binary distribution whose parameter is theta k and theta k is lesser than 0, lesser than or equal to 0, and smaller than or equal to 1 here. This means that according to equation 2.1, theta k is equal the probability of SK equal 1 given theta k, not the general notation P, denotes probability function in both discrete case and continuous case. Section 2, Bayesian optimization. In Bayesian inference, parameters is considered as a random variable which also follows distribution, and so if theta k has a variable probability P theta k, and hence the probability P SK equal 1 of of event SK equal 1 is the expectation of Bernoulli distribution P SK equal 1 given theta k within probability within the real probability P theta k according to equation 2.2. Not notation E denotes expectation of random variable. Going back to the example of lottery machine, P SK equal 1 is the probability that an arm K used lottery prize, which is called the winning probability of arm K. A gambler does not know exactly which arm is the best one to win a prize, and so he tries to choose an arm K having largest winning probability B SK equal 1. Consequently, if he wins SK equal 1, then the winning probability B at the case equal 1 is invalid. And otherwise, if he loses, then P of SK equal 1 is decreased in the next time. The gambler will continue to choose the arm whose winning probability is largest, and so on. Suppose the gambler choose arms to n time are considered as a sample dn fv1, fv1, fv2, fvn, where its observation fvi indicates that the gambler's selects arm vi at the ith time with result at vi with equal to 0 or 1, then decay denotes a subsample of dn in which sk is selected, and then sk and tk be the numbers of sk equal 1 and sk equal 0 respectively, which are extracted from decay. Suppose the case of base identically independent distribution IID criterion likelihood function of the case is here. Yes. It's just the product of theta k and the inverse of theta k by SK and TK terms. Sample the case here is called binomial sample when SK follows Bernoulli distribution, which leads to the event that the likelihood function of the K above follows binomial distribution. Marginal probability of the K within the variable probability B, probability of theta case in here, and posterior probability of theta case given sample the case according to base group is specified by equation 2.3, and the probability of SK equal 1 given the case of SK given the case is specified by equation 2.4 here. Obviously, for the example of lottery machines, the winning probability of arm case is expectation of parameter theta k within its posterior probability given sample the case. Therefore, given are parameters as parameter vector theta, theta 1, theta 2, theta r. The target function of Bernoulli's PBOs is essentially an index function specified by equation 2.5. The optimization problem is specified as a follow here. K star is the argument maximization of expectation of theta k given the case. Obviously, the target function is defined based on based on the posterior probability of theta case, which is now considered as a surrogate model of Bradley BBO, according to equation 2.6. Bradley BBO is BBOs because surrogate models of n correct function share the same parameter theta k. Acquisition function of Bradley BBOs is the same to target function according to equation 2.7. The group of nouns is how to specify the posterior probability of theta k. Suppose the prior probability of each theta k follow beta distribution according to equation 2.8. There are two hyperparameters of beta distribution in which A case indicates the number of successful outcomes and B case indicates the number of failed outcomes in A case SBK trials. Not gamma denotes gamma function, which is a continuous form of factorial function. Here, the gamma function is the integral. This is the integral. In this integral, we given variable probability, the probability of SI equal 1 is specified by equation 2.9. Given such sample decays, the posterior probability of each theta case is specified by equation 2.10, where SK and TK are the numbers of SK equal 1 and SK equal 0 respectively. Recall that such posterior probability of is also called Bradley BBO because the prior probability B of theta k and the posterior probability of theta k given the case have the same form. We are called conjugate distribution, and such conjugation is very important to Bayesian and inference. The probability of SK equal 1 given the case, which is also target function, is specified by equation 2.11. Formulation of surrogate models becomes neat because of the assumption of beta distribution with binomial sample when variable probability of theta follows beta distribution and SK follows Bradley distribution, so that the likelihood function of the k given theta k follows binomial distribution with binomial sample decays, then we obtain probabilistic conjugation in which the posterior probability of theta k given the k follows beta distribution. Going back to the example of lottery machine, it is easy to divide Bradley BBO with beta distribution, so in the next slide. There, this is the Bradley BBO's algorithm. Initialize hyperparameters alpha k, AK and BK of R distributions beta of theta k given alpha k BK. Why? The number of iterations is not many enough. Phi k minus 1 is an unindexed maximizer among R distribution beta, so that the expectation of theta k given the case is maximum. Here, this is the k minus n plus 1 is the argumax of a case at sk divided by AK, SK, SPK, STK. If the position S at the index K and plus 1 equal 1, then increasing the alpha, the R parameter at K and plus 1 increasing by 1. This parameter increasing by 1. Other one, if the position at the index k and s1 equal 0, then increasing the b parameter at k and s1 by 1, and increase n by 1. Because the expectation e of expectation of theta k given dk is essentially an estimate of theta k given binomial sample according to Bayesian statistics. The target function of binary BBO can be rewritten here. Fk is equal theta k theta hat k, where theta hat k is equal to expectation of theta k given dk. This implies that target function in binary BBO is identified by group probabilistic parameter, and hence, for example, given watery machine, its arm has no associated group probabilities, which cannot be applied into more complex system. Therefore, suppose its arm case is associated with a real number, vector sk, so that the target function is linear function of b dimension sk, and vector parameter w according to equation 2 von Tell. Not the simplicity denotes the transposition of operator of vector and matrix. There are the r group probability vectors s1, s2, sr, when the number of arms is r. Suppose the variable y equal the product, the dot product w and sk distributes not only with mean wsk and the various sigma square a is follow here. Not the tilde, the tie sign indicates group probabilistic distribution of a random variable and location, and denotes normal distribution. Essentially, this normal distribution is a likelihood function here. Normal distribution is also called Gaussian distribution. According to Bayesian inference, suppose parameter w distributes normally in variable with mean mu zero and covariance sigma zero a follow here. The distribution above is a multinormal distribution because w is a random vector variable. Multinormal distribution is also called multivariate normal distribution or multivariate Gaussian distribution. Suppose parameter sigma square follows inverse gamma distribution in variable with shape parameter alpha 0 and scale parameter beta 0. A follow here. Therefore, the parameter of anti-system laboratory machine is theta equal mu equal the set of either the set of mu sigma alpha beta, and the NBO for this parameter is called the normal inverse gamma NBO, NIG NBO, because it combines the multi-normal distribution and inverse gamma distribution by product operator. The variable probability of theta follows NIG distribution according to equation 2.13. The variable parameter is the theta 0, mu 0, sigma 0, alpha 0, beta 0. Beta 0, the sample dn now is dn equal s1, s2, sn. Of sn, where if si is some sk that the Gamma's series at the each time as follow here. Let y1, y2, yn be the output vector of s with a get function, where I is the dot product of w and si, and where y here. We have a yi. Fortunately, the posterior group probability of theta given sample dn is also NIG distribution with either group probabilistic conjugation with the variable rubberability. Of course, such material rubberability is a NICPBO circuit model according to equation 2.14. The posterior parameter is theta n, mu n, sigma n, alpha n, b n. Fortunately, theta n so was calculated from the n according to equation 2.115. Acquisition function of NIC's BBO is derived from target function and posterior mean mu n according to equation 2.16. Note the acquisition alpha of k given mu n is a function of, in that case, when theta n is determined. It is easy to derive NIC NPO algorithm shows in the next slide. Here, this table 2.1.2, NIC BBO algorithm. Initialize variable parameter theta 0, mu 0, sigma 0, alpha 0, beta 0. Why the number of iteration is not many enough? Update posterior parameter theta n, mu n, sigma n, alpha n, b n from s equal to n here. Phi k n plus 1 is an index maximizer of the acquisition function alpha of k given mu n among them are rubberability vectors sk here. K of n plus 1 is the acumax of the product mu n sk here. And then s the position sk n plus 1 to the symbol dn here. And increase the n by 1. And the loop repeat again. When FS does not have a specific explicit aspect of rubberability, which becomes an explicit parameter of surrogate model S of F given Dn, the corresponding BO becomes a non-parametric BO, NBO. The most popular technique to establish the surrogate model S for NBOs is using Gaussian Brochet regression (GBR) for modeling the surrogate model S. In other words, GBR is the surrogate model of NBO. This research focuses on NBO with GBR because the kernel function is very important to GBR. When it is used to not only build up GBR but also make GBR more smoother. Kernel function measures similarity between two variables, two bonds. According to that, the closer the two variables are, the larger their kernel function is. And less sigma si sj denotes kernel function of two variables si and sj. For example, the popular kernel function is simple squared exponential function here. In this research, this notation can denote absolute value of scala, len or module of vector, len or module of vector, determinant of matrix, and cardinality of set. Concretely, kernel function sigma SISJ is used to define covariance function of GBR as a convention, and let SISJ where I smaller than or equal to J denotes a sequential subset of S such that SIJ equals SI plus 1 until SA, and we can call that SI until J. Of course, we have SI until I equals SI given to subset SI until J and SK until L. The covariance function is specified by equation 217. Output of a covariance function is a covariance matrix if set output is invertible and symmetric. For n below, given sample Dn, Dn equals S from 1 to n, the consequential sequence y from 1 to n equal to the set of y1 equal fs1, y2 equal fs2, and yn equal fsn is established to distribute normally with various probability density function via BDF as follows here. Where in this notation f here, often denotes probability density function BDF, which is not concrete function, and notation n denotes normal distribution, which note that the general notation b denotes probability function in both discrete case and continuous case, whereas the term BDF focuses on probability function of continuous variable, not v and sigma are mean function and covariance function respectively. In this special case, covariance function sigma is a metric function defined based on kernel function. Exactly, sigma is metric by vector function if si is vector here. Of course, it is relevant. Sigma Si Sj of covariance function sigma of S1 to n and S1 to n is the kernel function, and recall that we have sigma of S and S from 1 to n is the convector, but sigma of S from 1 to n and S is the column vector. It is popular to define V Y from 1 to n based on the mean Y separately here. Moreover, for below, mean function V is often said to be 0 as follows. Mi y is equal to 0, so that mi y from 1 to n equals a 0 vector. Given variable s ZBR's circuit models is represented by the posterior PDF of y equal fx, given y from 1 to n s y from 1 to n s from 1 to n and s a follow here. This material BDF is derived from interesting properties of normal distribution, which will be mentioned in the next session. Note that mu of y given y from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, s n sigma square of y given s from 1 to n and s are mean and variance of the multi-normal material BDF of y given y from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, and s respectively here. Note this notation, sigma s from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, minus 1, denotes the inverse of covariance matrix. This is the output of variance function, sigma s from 1 to n, s from 1 to n. Please pay attention, m y from 1 to n is the realistic mean, which is currently determined by conversely knows mu of y given y from 1 to n minus 1 s from 1 to n minus 1 s here. The variance sigma square of y given s from 1 to n s is a function of only s, and so in practice mean function mu of y is said to be 0, so that the mean function mu of y given y from 1 to n s from 1 to n s is also function of only s2 as follows here. Please pay attention that m of y from 1 to n is the closest mean which is currently determined by reversing nodes mu n minus 1 of s specified by equation 2.18. The event that both mn of s and sigma square n of s are function of only s is necessary to determine acquisition function of B of later, with note that s from 1 to n and y from 1 to n were known. GBR circuit models is rewritten by equation 2.19 here. And where the mean vn s and the variance sigma square n of s is specified by equation 2.12. Therefore, the acquisition function alpha of s given fs, which will be based on mu, the mean mu and s, and sigma square and the variance sigma square n of s is denoted as follows here. This is the acquisition function. In this GBR, it is represented by two parameters, mu and s and sigma square n s, but such parameters are not included in the target function fs. And so this is a MBO given acquisition function alpha of s given mu and s and sigma square n s based on mean mu and s and variance sigma square n s, and also knows the sample dn. Dn is the equal to s from 1 to n in the setup s1, s2, sn, and let sn with 1 be a maximizer of the acquisition function alpha with regard to s, and hence sn with 1 will be updated continuously after every iteration until it reaches the anti-maximizer s star of s specified by equation 2.21. Sn1 is the argument max of the acquisition function. As a result, the Bosudo cut off NBO with GBR is 15 as shown in the next slide. Here, table 2.3, NBO algorithm with GBR. Initialize random dn equals s from 1 to n, s1, s2, sn. Initialize the mean m of y from 1 to n equal to the mu y from 1 to n. Y, the loop, this is the loop, y's maximizer s star is not reached, or the number of iterations is not many enough. Update the posterior mean mu and s and variance sigma square and s of GBR with sample dn as follows here. Determine acquisition function alpha of s given mu and s and sigma square and s based on the mean mu and s and variance sigma square and s of GBR. Find the net position s and s1 as a maximizer of the acquisition function alpha with regard to s here. S and S1 is the argument max of the acquisition function alpha. And then set m of the mean m of y and S1 equal mu n of S and S1. And then S and S1 to sample dn here. And increase n by 1. And the loop will be repeated again. In general, there are two important tasks of MBO, in which the first one is to determine the posterior mean mu and s and variance sigma n square s of GBR. The second one is to specify the acquisition function alpha, which is described shortly here. Detailed description of zebra and acquisition function will be mentioned in the next slide, next session. Note that the acquisition function alpha of S given V and S and sigma square and S is function of S. Recall that BO maximize the acquisition function alpha so as to search for the maximizer S star because the target function FS is assumed to be a black box. Seem to be a black box for BO, and BO creates reversely circuit model from which acquisition function is defined later. Acquisition function is especially important to NBO because NBOs do not know FS, and parameters of NBO circuit models are not relevant to FS. Acquisition function may not be strict with BBO, but it is very strict with NBO. Moreover, finding maximizer of acquisition function should be cheaper than finding maximizer of target function FS, so that researchers in optimization domain will be more attention to BO. There are some acquisition functions, for example, probability of improvement, expected improvement, and to research an upper confidence bound, but expected improvement EI. EI is the most popular one. EI is mentioned here, and other ones are described in the next session. Given sample Dn equal to S from 1 to n, S1, S2, Sn, and its evaluation is Y from 1 to n, Y1 to 2, Y1 to n, and let Yn star is the max of n Y, Y1, Y2, Yn, be the temporal maximum at current iteration of NBO algorithm. EI acquisition function is determined as follows here. Where sigma S to S is the corners standard deviation of Y given Y from 1 to N, S from 1 to N, and S here. The most important here is that phi, lowercase phi and uppercase phi are standard normal DBF and standard normal community distribution, standard normal CDF. Standard normal distribution equals standard Gaussian distribution here. This is the standard normal DBF, and it is the standard normal community distribution function. Mean and run of standard normal distribution are 0 and 1 respectively. Moreover, values of standard normal normal CDF were evaluated in practice. As a result, the maximizer Sn plus 1 of EI acquisition function in NBO algorithm at current iteration is determined as follows according to equation 2.22. Recall that defining and maximizing acquisition function is one of two most important tasks in BO, whereas the other one is to build up surrogate models. The essential criterion is that maximizing acquisition function, like EI, should be cheaper than maximizing analytic target function FS by analytic methods. Anyhow, BOC is always significant because the FS can be arbitrary or have no analytic formulation for BO. Non-parametric BOC is based on Gaussian process. This is the section 3, Gaussian process regression. Non-parametric BOS is based on Gaussian process regression. Zebra with in turn is based on Gaussian process. Therefore, we start the description of zebra with a concept of Gaussian process. Given a random process S at 1, at 2, at n, over and the tampon in with its key, where key belongs to 1, 2, and it's a random variable, and then S, uppercase S, upper and bone case S, is called Gaussian random Russian, or Gaussian Russian, GB in brief, if and only if, for any finite index set, T1, T2, Tk, of 1, 2, and where Tj belong to 1, 1, 2, and the subset ST1, ST2, STK, consider as the Tk dimension random vector ST1, ST2, STK follows a multi-normal distribution, known as a multivariate Gaussian distribution. Note, if Tj represents one dimension of the k-dimension random vector variable ST1, ST2, STK, moreover, please pay attention that any combination of ST1, ST2, STK follows a multi-normal distribution too. Without loss of generality, we denote the random process at random variable S, S1, S2, Sn, where T1, T2, Tk equal to 1, 1, 2, n, obeying multi-normal distribution, also called multivariate normal distribution, or multivariate Gaussian distribution, a follow according to equation 3.1, where mu s and sigma s are mean function and covariance function of s respectively. Not the simple root t denotes the transposition upper greater of vector and matrix, where the tilde sign indicates a probabilistic distribution of a random variable. GB's Gaussian process is known as an infinite multi-normal distribution, which is the generalized form of n-dimension multi-normal distribution, because and can approach positive infinity, yes, and equal to positive infinity, approach to possible infinity, and let f of s given v s sigma s be probability density function be f of s when s is the continuous we have here. This is normal distribution, where mean v s and covariance f s sigma s are function of s repeatedly, not in this resource notation f here. Often denotes BDF, which is not continuous function. And location n denotes a normal distribution. Probability function, distribution function, community distribution, distribution function CDF and BDF are terms which can be exchangeable in some cases. But the term BDF focuses on probability function of continuous variable, whereas the general location B denotes a probability function in both discrete case and continuous case. In literature, Vs is assumed to be zero as Vs is equal zero vector for convenience, but it can be defined as random process as itself. For example, Vs equal Sf. Besides, Vs can be customized according to concrete application. For example, it can be constrained as Vs equal V. However, is it better to set Vs equals zero vector for my opinion? As a convention in Gaussian process, output of a mean function is a mean, and so Vs also denotes theoretical mean of S. In general case, Vs is the vector function of combination of S1, S2, Sn belong to S. But as a convention, if Vsi depends only on Si, and moreover, Vsi has the same formulation of every Si. Therefore, Vs should be identified with Vsi or Vs, where S denotes any Si belonging to S here. Covariance function sigma S measures the correlation between random variables when random process moves them. In which the larger the given two random variables are, the larger their covariance. The two most important probabilities based on covariance function sigma s of random process are stationarity and isotopies among the four basic verbality, stationarity, isotopy, smoothness, and periodicity. Stationarity implies that the BDF FFS given VS of random process S will not be changed when the process is moved in time. For example, if new random variable S and S1 rise to edit, then means and conversion of all reverse variables Si where I is larger than or equal to 0, 1 and smaller than or equal to n in S will not be changed. It ruled that if GBS, the random process S, satisfies stationarity, sigma S will depend only on deviation Si subtract Sj. But the inverse statement is not asserted. However, if sigma S depends only on Euclidean distance Si Sj, then the Gaussian process S will satisfy isotropy. If S satisfies both stationary and isotropy, it is called a homogeneous process. In case where it in element of metric function sigma S depends on only Si and Sj, the stationary case and isotopies, it will result out of following the matrix according to equation 3.2. In this case, covariance function sigma S can be identified with its element function sigma Si Sj when the formulation of sigma Si Sj is not changed. Formula is enhanced. Sigma Si Sj is called the kernel function. Please pay attention that the term covariance function is slightly different from the term kernel function. When referring to only two variables Si and Sj, they are the same. When referring to one or two set of variables such as S and S star, the notation sigma S star, sigma S, and sigma S mention covariance function, a metric function whose elements are defined by kernel function if its element depends on only two variables like Si and Sj. If its sigma is a matrix by vector function, if its Si is vector. Output of a covariance function is a covariance matrix if such output is invertible and symmetric. In this case, a covariance function is identified with the covariance matrix. For explanation, suppose its I belong to S is scalar so that S is vector, and the output of covariance function sigma S is a covariance matrix. The multinormal BDF of S if formulated as follows here. This is normal function, normal distribution. However, if Si in GBR is arbitrary such as scalar, vector, and matrix, not sigma S minus 1 denotes the inverse of covariance matrix sigma S. Kernel function is not only essential to define covariance function of Gaussian process, but also used to make GBRs smoother. The following are some kernel functions here. This is the linear kernel function, and this is the square exponential kernel function, where L is a characteristic length scale of the process with reinforced similarity of Si and Sj. In this result, this notation denotes the absolute value of scalar length module of vector, determinant of matrix, and cardinality of set. Another convention, let S from I to J, where I smaller than or equal to J, denotes a sequential subset of S such that S from I to J equal Si, Si plus 1, Sj. Of course, we have S from I to I equal Si. In general case, S I from J is an arbitrary subset of distinguished variables. And let sigma Si S from J to K denotes the growth vector covariance function of Fi of Fi and S from J to K is a follow here. And let sigma S from J to K is Si denotes a column vector covariance function of S from J to K and Si a follow here. A convention let sigma S from I to J, S from K to L denotes a covariance function of S from I to J and S from K to L a follow according to equation 3.3. Firstly, the output of sigma S from I to J, S from K to L cannot be a covariance matrix if it is not squared. Not sigma S from I to J, S from K to L is a partition of sigma S, and we have sigma S equal sigma S from I to N, S from I to N, if denoting S1 here. S1, S1, Si, Si, S1, Sj, and S2, Sk, Sk plus 1, and Sl. We denote equation 3.4. Equation 2.4 is the convention here. Sigma Si, S2 equals sigma Si from I to J, Sk from K to L. S1 equals sigma S1 S1 equals sigma S1 equals sigma S from I to J, S from I to J equals sigma S from I to J. Gaussian Rosset regression ZVR is based on Gaussian Rosset ZV when there is a target function with a test to it S square S represent any Si in S such that Y equals Fs. Please distinguish the target function f from the not formal notation f here of the probability density function BDF. Of course, y and yi is also random variable, and we also have yi equal fsi. Besides, in context of regression model, the target function fs is not a formal function with axiomatic operator, and exactly is a mapping between s and y. For example, sample SY has two paired data sets S and Y in which for every SI belonging to S there is a YI belong to Y, and hence the equation Y equals FS only indicates such mapping. ZVR models tries to represent overall regressive BDF of Y from its reverse squares, which will be explained later. And as suppose we had a regression model of Gaussian process S, S1, S2, Sn, and target function Y equals Fs, assuming that the prior BDF of Y given S is also derived from the multinormal BDF of S here. And therefore we have the BDF of I of Y given S according to equation 3.5, where we and sigma denote mean function and covariance function in our formality respectively, and sigma S equals sigma S. The equation above implies that the prior BDF of the Gaussian Rosset Y is initialized with the BDF of the Gaussian Rosset S. Mean vector and covariance matrix of Y are mu Y and sigma SS within the BDF F of Y given S mu sigma. Respectively, the mean function mu Y is redefined here with variable Y, but it should be the same to the mean function mu S in formulation if mu S can be extended with the lower higher dimensional space. For instance, if mu s is defined as an identity function Me as ego as then me y will be defined as identity function me y, ego y1, y2, yn for simplicity. Me y is often said to be zero as me y equal zero vector. Is it also better than better to set me y equal zero vector? Now, suppose we randomize a new set of variable x star. X star is Sn not 1, Sn not 2, and Sn plus k, and obtain their variated values y star equal f x star yn not 1, yn n not 2, yn not 1, yn not 2, yn n plus k. Similarly, mean vector covariance matrix of y star mu star and sigma s star within the BDF f of y star given s star mu sigma respectively. Of course, the mean function mu for both y and y star is the same. Consequently, the zone BDF of y and y star, which is of course multinormal distribution, is denoted by equation 3.6. Where a mean vector and covariance matrix of the zone BDF of y and y star are mu y star and here sigma s sigma s star sigma s s star s sigma s star s star. This is the partition of the matrix. Repeatedly, the equation above is one of interesting properties of multinormal distribution. As a result, Gaussian process regression zebra model of dependent variable y is a conditional BDF of y star given y s and s star such as f of y star given y s s star mu sigma, which is also predictive BDF of y star because it can be used to predict next occurrence of y. From interacting properties of multinormal distribution, it is easy to draw ZBR from the zone BDF according to equation 3.7. Yes, this is the zone BDF f of y star given y s star mu sigma. Yes, this is the zone BDF. It's very important. Where mean vector mu y star given y s star and covariance matrix sigma y star given s star are here. This equation is the most important. This is the core. Yes, it is the core of Gaussian process regression, and it's a regression equation. When y star is variable, then mu y star is still mean function, but mu y was determined, and hence, for making clear this variableness, and let m y replace mu y so that the mean vector mu y star given mu of y star given y s star and covariance matrix sigma of y star given s star are rewritten by equation 3.a. Equation 3.a is the strength of this equation, and it's the most important. It's the most important equation with its user over this result. The quantity my is a heuristic mean at the beginning of any zebra algorithm. It is defined as the same to the mean function mu. For example, my equal mu y equal zero vector, my equal mu y equal y, etc. But at the later phase of any zebra algorithm, it is recurrently determined by the first node mu y here. Mu y from 1 to n0 s. From 1 to n is 0 as a follow according to equation 3.9. This equation is is not determined. It's either way to explain the idea. The idea M Y is currently determined by the first known me of Y given Y from 1 to N zero S from 1 to N zero S here. Obviously, the zero of Y star distribution normally with mean vector mu and covariance matrix sigma mu of Y star given Y S star and sigma of Y star given S star. Indeed, the zebra Gaussian Brochet regression F of Y star given Y S star mu sigma is but zero BDF of Y whose variable BDF is F of Y given S mu sigma. Initializing such variable BDF by the BDF of S as F of Y given S equal F of S is not totally correct, but implicit bias will be decreased after the posterior BDF F of Y star given Y S star mu sigma is updated. And we have the following summary equation 3.10. Until the zebra of Y star depends on Y S and S star, the main semantic meaning of the regression model here is mentioned mainly that Y star is determined based on its reverse one Y when both of them are assumed to be based on S via the BDF of Y as F of Y given S mu sigma, and the BDF of Y star as F of Y star given Y star mu sigma. This implies that S is the intermediate bond for the probabilistic dependence of Y star on Y. In the most general case, when random variable random Brochet Y is associated with a random error whose mean and variance are zero and then class square, repeatedly with assumption that on Yi belong to into Y, issue noisy, which obey the same error distribution. Therefore, the variable BDF of Y given as is liberated. A follow here, and the variance at the sigma, the delta square I, where I is the identity matrix. So mean vector and covariance matrix of Y are mu Y and sigma SS at delta square I within the BDF F of Y given S mu sigma repeatedly. Consequently, the zone BDF of Y and Y star is liberated. Here, I follow. As a result, mean vector mu of Y star given Y S star and covariance sigma of Y star given S star of the Gaussian Brochet regression F of Y star given Y S star mu sigma are specified by equation 3.11. Here. And you focus here. Yes, it is noise. It is noise variance. The equation above is the most general formulation of zebra with occurrence of noise or errors. However, we can ignore the error variance delta square I without the loss of generality. If S star and Y star are 1 in 11 vectors such that S star equals S n less 1 and Y star equals Y n less 1 and let S from 1 to n equals S equals S star, Y from 1 to n equals Y and Y equals Y star. The zebra of Y star, which is now zebra of Y, becomes equation 3.10, where mu of Y given Y from 1 to n, S from 1 to n, S, and sigma square of Y given S from 1 to n as a mean and variance of posterior BDF of y given y from 1 to n s from y from 1 to n s from 1 to n and s according to equation 3.13 here. Equation 3.13. The equation above, with single variables s and y, single posterior process is popular in PO, especially s is vector and y is scalar. Onto s and y can be arbitrary such a scalar vector matrix with not that high-dimensional space require tensor products. For example, believe a tension that m of y from 1 to n in zebra algorithm is a realistic mean, which is recurrently determined by recursively knows mu of y given y from 1 to n minus 1 s from 1 to n minus 1 s according to equation 3.14 and not here. It's the explanation of the sigma of s 1 s 1 by n sigma s from 1 to n sigma of s from 1 to n s. Suppose only s is considered variable where is y from 1 to n and s from 1 to n are known, then mean function mu is said to be 0 as mu y is equal 0, so that both the mean mu of y given y from 1 to n s from 1 to n s and variance sigma square of y given s from 1 to n s are function of only s a flow here. It is the mean function mu n s and sigma n square s. Recall that m of y from 1 to n is the closest mean, which is recurrently determined by reversely node mu n minus s here. M y n equal mu n minus 1 of s n. The event that the mean function mu n s and variance function sigma n square s are function of only is necessary to define acquisition function of optimization class in BO. Zebra can be executed continuously with new s star while the on s star is incorporated into actual zebra s Gaussian process s. In practice, such continuous execution is implemented as an iterative algorithm whose iteration has a following step in the next slide. Table 3.1 ZBR algorithm has two steps. Step 1, set new S star by this equation. This equation to calculate the mean function mu y star given y s star and covariance matrix covariance function sigma of y star given s star. And step 2, set m of y equal mu y of y star given y s star and set s equal union of s and s star. In step 1, the covariance matrix sigma fs is not recomputed entirely because some of its elements sigma sj were determined before. Because the Gaussian process s will get used when the iterative algorithm repeats many iterations and s star is incorporated into s over and over again, it is possible to apply first order Markov property so that each iteration remembers only one reverse s. Therefore, we can assign s star to s as s equal s star in step 2 so that the iterative algorithm run faster and saves more computational resources as in the next line. Table 3.12, CBR algorithm with the first order markup property. Step one, set new S-star and calculate the mean function and sigma function according to equation here. And step two, setting M of Y equal mu of Y star given Y as S-star and setting S equal S-star. However, this advantage of first order markup property cannot be applied into BO by defining how to test new S-star with acquisition function, because it is necessary to look anti-estimate forward and backward to find out potential global optimizer. The use of markup property will be appropriate to cost of reduction and estimation in with anti-time series are split into many smaller time windows, where it is necessary to remember W windows with W order markup property. Shortly, the assignment S equals S-star is suitable to forward modeling. Zebra focuses mainly on the regressive posterior covariance matrix sigma of Y star given S S-star with a kernel function sigma of Si, Sj, because asserting the regressive posterior mean function V of Y star given Y as S-star via asserting the mean function V of Y is unnecessary due to this equation. As usual, mean function V of Y star are set to be 0 such as V Y star equal 0 vector, so that here we see indeed an arithmetic regression of Y star on Y, S and S star in addition to the main semantic meaning that the posterior BDF of Y star given Y is the main regression. However, it is still better to define exactly the mean function V of Y in case of predicting more precisely confident intervals of Y based on S, because the equation above. Which implies variation of Y according to variation of S from the origin. It is not a real value of Y. But another way, if setting Y star equal Y star equals Y star, also describing Y of Y equal Y, so that this equation is not a regression function. Would it be impossible to predict Y star based on S star if Y star is unknown? Therefore, I propose a technique based on the linear regression model to define mu Y star with constant that it enables mu of Y star or mu of Y star uppercase Y star depend only on Y star, for instance here. Not Y star represent any Yi belonging to the subset Y star Yn-1, Yn-2, Yn-k, and S star represent any Sy belonging to the subproset S star Sn-1, Sn-2, Sn-k. And let Vs be the transformation function which transform S space into Y space such that V is invertible according to equation 3.15. Therefore, V should be defined by constant that S space and Y space have the same dimension for information reservation. The simplest form of V is the identity function Vs equals S. And let Z star be a regressive estimate of S star according to equation 3.16. Here, Z star equal A star S star, where A star is regressive coefficient. How to calculate A star from sample S star V inverse of Y star will be defined later. Please pay attention that this Gaussian regression is totally different from the regression meaning of GVR via posterior BDF. And let Y star be an estimate of Y star from S star with association of Gaussian regression model and transformation function phi according to equation 3.17. Obviously, we have Z star equal the inverse of phi inverse of Y hat star, and let the absolute of S star, absolute of Y, and absolute of Y star. But this is they are the cardinalities, also the main dimension. This is the cardinality, is the number of the enlargement of the vector inside this set. Also dimension of X, S star, Y, and Y star repeatedly. Of course, we have the cardinality of S equal the cardinality of Y, the cardinality of S star equal the cardinality of Y star, for example. And we also have cardinality of S equal cardinality of Y equal N, and cardinality of S star equal cardinality of Y star equal K. Concentration ratio CR of a subproject which is a bond density of such subproject is defined by the ratio of cardinality of such subproject to the cardinality of antiproject. For example, CR is not the concentration ratio of S star over S, and S star is specified by equation 3.18. It's either cardinality of E-dash, cardinality of S-star divided by the sum of cardinality of S and S-star. Symbol A also being the classic coefficient estimated from the symbol S and phi inverse of Y was determined before. The mean function mu-star of S-star is robust. A, the weighted estimation of the concentration ratio of S and S star a follow according to equation 3.19. As a result, the two-step at each iteration of the iterative algorithm for estimating GBR are fine-tuned, showed in the next slide. Here, table 3.3, GBR algorithm with linear regression. Here's the two-step, step 1. They have many iterations, and each iteration has two steps. Step 1, test new the S star, calculate A star from the sample coefficient A star from the sample S star, phi inverse of Y star, and calculate the mean function of mu of Y star given S star, and the covariance function sigma of Y star given S star. Step 2. M of Y equal mu of Y star given S star, setting A by A star, and setting S in the union of S and S star, and setting S equal S star, where mu star S star is determined based on the mu S star A follow here. Not the vector phi inverse of Y star is determined here. Both mean vector mu of Y star given at S star and covariance matrix sigma of Y star given at S star of GBR with linear regression are free from Y because they are totally based on only S and S star. For interval estimation of Y star given with given S star, suppose GBR algorithm finished obtaining regression coefficient A after some iterations on S. The mean function mu of Y star is reduced with S star A follow here. Mu star S star equal phi of A S star. As a result, the confidence interval of Y star, which is the bare mu of Y star given at S star and the sigma of Y star given at S star, is determined a follow according to equation 3.20. Recall that MY is a realistic mean vector with a recurrent determined by reversely knows mu of y given s from 1 to n0 s here by this equation. Because the Gaussian Rosette regression g bar algorithm here defines the mean function mu of y star based on multiple linear regression MLR models, it is necessary to describe MLR in short. Given a dependent random vector variable z, z1, z2, zm, and an independent random variable s1, 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 s2, sn, MLR tries to establish linear relationship between z, z1, z2, zm, and s so that z is the sum of linear combination of s and a random error vector epsilon by equation 3.21. S equals the regressor and z equals the response, whereas a is the vector, a is alpha 0, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 is the alpha n is the whereas a is equal a zero a zero a one a two a n is the m's n which one regressive coefficient matrix according to equation 3.22. Symbol epsilon distributes the normal with mean vector zero mean vector and covariance matrix sigma, then z distributes a normal with mean vector as and covariance sigma due to equation 3.23. Not e and v denote theoretical expectation and variance respectively, and sigma is mm's inverter matrix. This implies that the BDF of random variable z is here. Is here. MLR multiple linear regression of z given s is built from sample s z of psi n in form of data matrix a follow according to equation 3.24. Therefore, si and si and zi e. They are the instance of intensity of regressor S and the response Z. As the I the grow up matrix S Z as the convention, we can connect the data set S and Z of MLR here with the Gaussian process S star and the set P inverse of Y star aforementioned. Repeatedly, if removing the first column of variance 1 from dataset S according to equation 3.25. The essence of MLR is to estimate the regressive coefficient matrix A and the covariance matrix sigma by applying maximum likelihood estimation MLE's method. Method, we obtain the estimator a hat and sigma hat of a and sigma according to equation 3.26 here. Recall that Bayesian optimization BO maximizes the acquisition function alpha of s given f s the surrogate s model s. So as to search for maximizer S star, especially parametric BO and BOs based on Gaussian process regression, CBR requires the support of acquisition function to guide the movement of S in the search space, so as to reach the maximizer S star. Moreover, acquisition function of NBOs is created from the GBR Sugarit model. Concretely, it is defined with two essential parameters such as posterior mean VNS and variance sigma and square S of GBR here. This is the mean and the variance. Note that M of Y from 1 to N is related mean, which is currently determined by the first nodes V and minus 1 S here. M of YN equals V and minus SN. This is the reason that acquisition function of embryos is denoted as of the acquisition function alpha in embryo. Therefore, this session focuses on embryo acquisition function GBA surrogate models of embryos is represented by the posterior BDF of Y equal FS given Y from 1 to N, S from 1 to N, and S a follow here. Both mean mean and S and variance sigma N square S are functions of only S because Y from 1 to N and S from 1 to N were known, which is necessary to determine acquisition function with a function of S2. Not in this research, notation often denotes BDF with a not concrete function and notation and denotes normal distribution. The normal BDF of Y equal FS given Y from 1 to N and S from 1 to N and S a formulated a follow here. This is the normal distribution. This BDF should be standardized into standard normal BDF phi z, because the values of standard normal community distribution function standard normal CDF uppercase phi z were calculated in practice. Standard normal distribution is also called standard Gaussian distribution if variable y is standardized into variable z such that z equal here equal y subtract vns divided by sigma ns, then distribution of y is equivalent to distribution of z via its bdf phi z also its cdf uppercase phi z according to equation 411. Where the quantity sigma ns equal the root of sigma n square s is the cross standard deviation of y given y from 1 to n, s from y from 1 to n, and s not standard normal BDF has a mean zero and variance, and we have an important property of standard normal distribution here. This property is very important. If the BDF of y is standardized, the statement that y distributes normally given y from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, and s with mean v and s and variance sigma n square s will be equivalent to the statement that the distribution of z given y from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, and s is standard normal distribution where z equal y subtract mu and s divided by sigma n s. Of course, we have equation 412, y equal mu and s s sigma n s z. Recall that the acquisition function alpha of S given F and surrogate model S based on mean mean S and variance sigma n square S of ZVR surrogate model is denoted a follow which implies that it is a function of S here. Recall that given acquisition function alpha based on mean S and sigma n square S and also know sample dn equal s from 1 to n, s1, s2, sn, n, and let sn less 1 be a maximizer of the acquisition function alpha in embryo at the current iteration, and we have sn less 1 is the argument max of the acquisition function alpha. There are some acquisition function, for example, probability of improvement, expected improvement, and to be such, and upper confidence bound, and let S star and Y star equal FS star be the maximizer, and it repeat the maximum value of target function to width on acquisition M, both probability of improvement BI technique and expected improvement EI technique belong to improvement approach in which their acquisition function, which are also utility function in decision theory, are expectation of redefine the repetitive improvement function, but their definition of improvement function are different. For instance, the improvement function denoted IS says the deviation between the next value y equal fs and the current and temporal maximum yn star equal fs star with the expectation that y will be larger than yn star as much as possible for searching realistic maximizer star, otherwise is zero. And here is the max of the subtraction y and y star and zero, the max of subtraction fs and y and star and zero, not given sample dn equal s from 1 to n, s1, s2, sn, and its evaluation y from 1 to n, y1, y2, yn, we have a y star is a max among of max among y1, y2, yn, which is the temporal maximum at current iteration of NBO algorithm. When the BDF of y is standardized, y equal mu ns at sigma ns z, then the improvement function is written by equation 413. Here, equation 413. Probability of improvement PI technique defines the acquisition function a probability of IS larger than zero, which means that the probability of event that next candidate of target maximizer is larger than the old one must be maximized. Here, alpha BIS is the probability of IS larger than zero, not that the notation B denotes the probability. As a result, BI acquisition function is determined as follows according to equation 414 here. It is very simple. The BI acquisition function is equal to the community probability standard probability of VNS subtract Y star is divided by the deviation alpha and is, and this is the loop. Here. Therefore, the maximizer S n less 1 of BI acquisition function in NBO algorithm at current iteration is determined as follows. Here, S n less 1 is argument max of the uppercase the community function, community standard normal function of mu ns subtract yn star divided by the deviation sigma ns. Expected improvement EI technique defines the acquisition function as the expectation of IS, which means that the mean of the event that net candidate of target maximizer is larger than the on one must be maximizer. Here, this is the expectation. Not such expectation of IS is determined with standard BDF PZ given y from 1 to n, s from 1 to n, and s. As a result, EI acquisition function is determined as follows according to equation 415. Here. The next slide is this equation, and this is the loop, and you see that This should be not so difficult. Just you calculate the integral, and some property of standard normal distribution. Here. And 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 here. Final. The loop is finished. Therefore, the maximizer Sn is one of Ei acquisition function in NBO algorithm at current iteration is determined a follow. Here. Unimportant null of NBRs is thus maximizing acquisition function should be cheaper than maximizing target function FS if FS is analytic function with a appropriate to analytic approach. Fortunately, it is not requisite to find out the global maximizer of acquisition function because essentially NBO is a reinforcement algorithm whose solution candidate for S star is improved progressively, and moreover, acquisition function itself must trade up between exploitation, conversion in searching maximizer, and exploration searching global maximizer for NBO. Therefore, it is possible to apply traditional mathematical methods such as gradient descent for obtaining the local maximizer as an one of acquisition function. It is only necessary to check for order degravity known as gradient of acquisition function when traditional optimization methods like gradient descent require existence of present, because BI is similar than AI and EI. How to maximize BI is mentioned here as an example of acquisition maximization. Here. Now we only need to determine the gradient of the acquisition alpha BI with regard to variable S and let sigma quark SIS be gradient from order degravity of sigma SIS with regard to S given nodes SI here, SI1, SI2, SIN, and unknown S, S1, S2, SN here. As a convention, sigma quark SIS is growth vector. If covariance function produces symmetric matrix, then sigma cos SIS equal sigma cos SSI. For example, given symbol square exponential kernel function, yes, its kernel function is the exponential function of the deviation, the deviation square minus deviation square of SSI divided by 2, its gradient with regard to S is here, very simple. And let sigma cos of S from 1 to N S be gradient of sigma of S from 1 to N S. Essentially, it is a matrix, but written a column vector whose element is row vector here. Its element is row vector. If covariance function produces a symmetric matrix, we have this is the simple property of symmetric matrix. Gradient of mu ns and sigma square ns with regard to S are specified by equation formula 6. And this is the derivative of mu ns and sigma square s. And equation formula 6 is not so difficult. It is derived from the gravities of high dimensional derivative of matrix and vector, and not sigma of S from 1 to n, S from 1 to n is invertible and symmetric. Because of sigma ns is the root of sigma n square of s, we have the resonance of sigma ns a follow here. And now, let zns equal yn star subtract mu ns divided sigma ns deviation sigma ns a function of s. It gradient with regard to S is specified by equation 4.7. Here, this is the gradient derivative of ZNS. Gradient of BI is totally determined a flow according to equation 4.8. Here, finally, this is we obtain the derivative of the acquisition function. PI, property improvement, acquisition function according to equation 4.8, and where ZNS equal the YN star subtract mu N star divided by sigma NS. It is possible to apply traditional methods like gradient descent to find out local maximizer at N plus 1 of PI, because PI gradient is determined given S. Similarly, it is easy to obtain gradient of EI acquisition function because gradients of mu ns and sigma n square s are most important, which are the base to calculate gradients of PI and EI. And equation 4.9 specify the gradient BI gradient here. Intron. Gradients of mu ns and sigma n square s are based on the gravity of the kernel function, the gravity sigma cos si of the kernel function. And so, differentiability of kernel function always assures feasibility of improvement approach. As aforementioned, optimization problem with BO is maximization problem by default. However, which one between maximization, minimization, and maximization can be determined by changing activation. Changing the acquisition function a little bit in BO. Exactly, BO minimization can be obtained by changing the definition of improvement function. IS a little bit. Concretely, given net value y equal fs and temporal minimum yn star equal fss star, the improvement function for minimization is specified with expectation that y is small, will be smaller than yn star as much as possible. I follow here. A tilde s is the max of the max of y star subtract y at zero here. As a result, BI acquisition function and EI acquisition function for minimization are. It is very easy. It is just a change of viewpoint to obtain how to minimization, how to minimize the correct function. The acquisition function are maximized locally by traditional methods like gradient descent at current iteration as usual. Here, Sn plus 1 is the argument of alpha tilde BIS for minimization. Sn plus 1 is the argument max of alpha tilde EIS for minimization. Another simple acquisition function called upward confident bound UCB. UCB function is based on confidence interval of zebra, which is determined by posterior mean VNS and various sigma n square s of zebra here. Therefore, the confidence interval of zebra is here. Mu ns subtract sigma ns and nguyên s, s minus, where the upper bound is nguyên s, s, the sum. Upper bound is sum of nguyên s and sigma ns. And the lower bound is the subtract nguyên s and sigma ns. Obviously, UCB acquisition function is composed of set upper bound, upper bound and a parameter lambda a follow according to equation for 4110. The maximizer S and one of UCB acquisition function in embryo algorithm at current iteration is determined a follow here. The parameter lambda controls trade off of exploitation and exploration in which the exploitation aspect indicates that NBO goes forward fast seeking maximizer, whereas the exploitation aspect indicates that NBO goes forward seeking global maximizer. If lambda is small, exploitation is focused that so that NBO can converge fast, but the maximizer S star can be local. If lambda is large, exploration is focused or such that embryo can find out the global maximizer, but its conversion can be slow with not that a terminated condition for embryo iterative algorithm can be the maximum number of iterations. It is easy to apply traditional optimization method like the Bayesian descent to find out local maximizer S and root 1 of UCB because the it Bayesian is determined simply a follow here. Very simple. The Bayesian of the UCB acquisition function is the sum of Bayesian of nguyên S and lambda sigma ns, the Bayesian. The region of lambda and region of the sigma and s. For minimization, UCB acquisition function is changed into lower confidence about LCB function a follow here. Alpha LCB s is the subtraction between mu and s and lambda sigma and s. For minimization, LCB is minimized locally by traditional methods like Bayesian descent as usual at current iteration when its question is determined simply to here. SNH1 is an argument of alpha LCBS for minimization. In general, UCB acquisition function is seamless acquisition function, but for my opinion, it is not as good as EI. Because essentially UCB is the crowd box containing the target function fs, and so it cannot simulate exactly bits of fs, whereas EI has advantage of heuristic information about bits of fs via the probability distribution of GVR, and EI balances exploitation and exploration via its inside mean under the GVR distribution. This is the last session, session 5, discussion. The main purpose of Bayesian optimization BOC is to solve the global optimization problem where the target function fs is less box. The event that fs is not necessary to be defined analytically. Broaden application of BO in which reinforcement learning and robotics learning are suitable application of BO. Essentially, in deep learning, where is a stochastic gradient descent SGD method is appropriate and successful to train main parameter of neural network such as weight and biasy. BO which will consider the anti-neural networks, a black box can be applied to train other augmented parameters such as learning Leningrad. I said a Leningrad of SGD because SGD cannot learn such augmented parameters. In the situation of data stream and rework indetermination, it is impossible to set the Leningrad of SGD to be inversely proportional to iteration, because such iteration cannot be counted exactly in such situation. But it is also not good to fit such learning grade. A possible solution is to use BO to find out the optimal learning grade in the backup process in parallel with SGD process. Recently, because of Netbox, I spent a BO transfer learning is applied into improving BO to select appropriate server grid models and appropriate acquisition function. In this research, Gaussian process regression zebra is a surrogate model for non-parametric Bayesian optimization and BO, but there are other surrogate models such as the Bayesian neural network and neural process. Discussion. In general, the research focuses on non-parametric Bayesian optimization and BO, although there are some interesting aspects of parametric Bayesian optimization BBO. Strictness is emphasized in some researches, but otherwise need only reasonableness, especially applied research or heuristic research. Although MBO belongs to applied mathematics, its mathematics-based is strict even if a group of surrogate models and acquisition function maximization is seemingly tricky. Therefore, its cost advice is that MBO is in turn based on traditional convex optimization methods like gradient descent to maximize the acquisition function, which means that MBO requires other knowledge outside its circle, while heuristic methods like particle swarm optimization BSO and RB colony ABC do not require mathematical constraints. Anyhow, MBO is a significant solution of global optimization problem because within requisite assumption of two strict mathematical constraints, the process of applying mathematical will be hesitative. Therefore, the main problem here is the effectiveness of MBOs is balancing exploration and exploitation for search in global optimizer. Heuristic methods are methods like BSO are rooted their simplicity and feasibility when they do not focus on complicated mathematical tools, although there are some researchers trying to apply mathematical theories into explaining them for human research. Whether thinking via theories is prior to natural imitation or vice versa is a big question whose answer can be dependent on individual. This question is equivalent to the other question that which one among logicality and imagination is important. The list of reference, there are two main reference. The first one is a tutorial on Bayesian optimization by Brazil, and the second important reference, yes, is the article taking the human out of the loop, a review of Bayesian optimization by Sariari, Swirsky, Wang, Adams, and Retas. Thank you very much for your listening and attending. I am very honored and happy to answer your question. I'm also very honored and happy to connect with all of you. Thank you.